Morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm firefighter Steve McDonald from the Public Information Office, and welcome you here to Florian Hall for this great day. I ask that you please stand while we have the entrance for our graduating recruits. Present to you now the 64 graduates of the Boston Fire Academy. Feel free to clap when they enter the hall. I ask that you please remain standing for the presentation of our colors by the Boston Fire Honor Guard. Please remain standing for our singing of our national anthem by our a cappella quartet.
We stand.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
I ask that you please remain standing while we have opening prayer by our Chief Chaplain, Father Daniel Mahoney, and then to remain standing while the colors are retired after the prayer.
The eternal and loving God, the creator of our human family, we ask your blessings and graces on these firefighters, graduating this morning from the Fire Academy of the Boston Fire Department. Bless them and bless their work, and grant your blessings to their families. Grant them, O Lord, the courage, the strength, and the wisdom in the performance of their everyday duties as firefighters, as members of the Boston Fire Department and the Chelsea, Dedham, Malden, Marshfield, and Wellesley Fire Departments as well. May St. Florian, the firefighter's patron and protector, protect them and all our firefighters and all families now and always. And just before we conclude the prayer, may we have a moment of silence for a magnificent friend of all firefighters in the state of Massachusetts, Senator Kenneth Donnelly, an active senator who died the other day, whose funeral will be on Saturday. Ken was a Lexington firefighter. He was a member of 1491 Local in Lexington, became Executive Secretary Treasurer of the PFFM of Massachusetts, and most recently a firefighter. May we bow our heads just for a moment to pray for Ken. All this we ask in God's name, amen.
On guard, right? Four, mom.
Just wait here. Yeah, until they get out. No, I'm going to have some. Yeah, I'll go over this. I'll just stay right over here for a second. Yeah. Sweet. When I go, she just have one more thing. Yeah, one more thing. Got another announcement?
Yeah, one second.
Please be seated. Before we begin the formal graduation program, we have a special presentation, and I want to call up here Commissioner Chief of Department Joseph Finn.
Thank you, Stevie. Before we begin the graduation proceedings, I'd first like to take a moment to for a little special presentation. Back last year in May, we christened a new fireboat, and we named it the Father Dan. And it is in honor of Father Dan Mahoney, who has over 53 years as the chaplain of the Boston Fire Department. So he is the most senior member of the department, by far. And a round of applause, yeah, for sure. He also has over 60 years of a priest, being a priest, and also almost 50 years serving St. Francis de Sales Parish in Charlestown. So you can imagine through the tragedies and triumphs of this department through 53 years, how much Father Dan has meant to all of us spiritually, as a friend, a confidant, and we just wanted to make a little presentation today of a picture of the Father Dan with the badge, and also a little inscription, which I like to read. To Father Dan Mahoney, appointed Assistant Chaplain of the Boston Fire Department on October 1st, 1964, promoted Assistant Senior Assistant Chaplain in July of 1972, and appointed Chief Chaplain of the Boston Fire Department on October 1st, 1991, in recognition of the christening of the Father Dan. Thank you.
Thank you all so very, very much. That was truly a surprise. But you know, in the fire service and the new candidates graduating today, we are truly sisters and brothers. It's a magnificent sisterhood and brotherhood. And as all of us have seen it as the years go by, we pray today that these new graduates will see that as well. There is one thing we all learn early on the job, and that is we watch each other's back. And that you do so very, very well. I want to thank you, Commissioner and President Parris, of the local 718 firefighters and all of my sisters and brothers in the department. It has been a pleasure. It's been a magnificent gift and a great blessing. And as Captain Walsh and I said a few moments ago, every day we come to work is a happy day and it's a blessing. May that be true of all of our firefighters and all of you, their families here today. Take good care, and as the firefighters always say, stay safe. And I say to all of you, stay safe. Thank you.
Thank you, Father. Our first speaker this morning, the mayor of the city of Boston, Marty Walsh.
Thank you, Steve. When Father Mahoney came back to the microphone, I thought he was going to ask for a second collection for his parish. You forgot that, Father. We'll pass the hat around in a minute. I want to thank Father Mahoney. I've known Father Mahoney for over 20 years. His former state representative is the Corporation Counsel for the City of Boston, Gino Flaherty, and he spent a lot of time talking about Father Mahoney, and I know that you've prayed with a lot of families who've lost loved ones on this job over the years, and I want to thank you for that and being such a strong light in our city, a spiritual light in our city. So again, Father, thank you, and everything, any honor, recognition you get, you deserve. You've done great by our city, so thank you very much. Good morning to everyone, and I want to thank Commissioner Finn. There is no question about this, that we have the best fire commission in the country right here in the city of Boston. In 3 years, the advancements that this fire department has made has been incredible, and I want to thank Joe for his leadership. I also want to thank Richie Parrish, president of Local 718, and by far there's no better partner on the labor side than Richie Parrish. I want to thank you, Richie, for that as well. We might have our disagreements every now and then, Richie and myself in the city, but at the end of the day, Richie is always advocating for the men and women of the Boston Fire Department, making sure that their equipment is the right equipment, making sure that their benefits are the right benefits, making sure that they get what they earn every single day. So, Richie, I want to thank you for your friendship as well, and thank you for pushing us in the city so we can have a better fire department. Thank you very much. Thank you. We're also joined by several of the members of the Boston City Council. The chairwoman of the Public Safety Committee, City Council Andrea Campbell's with us. Thank you, Council Campbell, for being with us today. He's getting tired of hearing this, but a city council has been on the council for nearly a decade and has also been a member of the city for nearly 40 years, and he's retiring. And this is his last graduating class that he'll be at City Council Billy Lenihan from South Boston, South Bend. And another city council who's in his first term, who is not, second term actually, who has not missed a graduation of any public safety office, that's Tim McCarthy. Thank you, Councilor. And on behalf of Councilor Campbell, Councilor Lenihan, and Councilor McCarthy, it's my pleasure to congratulate the newest members of the Boston, Greater Boston firefighters community, all of the firefighters here today. Thank you, congratulations. I just want to take a minute to address all the friends and family members of the graduates. Firefighting is a demanding career, and it's not just firefighters who need to be strong, as their families as well. Every day you support them, you motivate them, and that's for the entire city of Boston. We are grateful for you and for the other towns represented here. Thank you very much, because I know these last few months have not been easy, because they take orders at the academy, and they come home and try and give orders to you. So that's, you know, but I want to thank you all. Father Mahoney and Steve McDonald mentioned this already, but I want to just take a moment also to acknowledge a dear friend and colleague we lost this week, Senator Kenny Donnelly. As Father Mahoney mentioned his career as a Lexington firefighter, also working for the Mass Association of Professional Firefighters, I had a chance to meet Kenny when he was the financial secretary of that organization. He was an advocate for working class people. His job was to fight for firefighters. But any time that there was a fight at the State House, as a legislative person, he would back it up. I had the great honor of serving with him in the legislature. Kenny was in the Senate, I was in the House. There was many times that we would have bills, legislation, not just concerning the fire department, but concerning other people. And Kenny and myself were always on the same page, always fighting for the advancing of working class people. He is a great loss. And to his family, I want to say thank you. Thank you for allowing Kenny to serve his entire career as a public servant, first as a firefighter, then working in the Mass Association, and then as a state senator. Kenny, like many of you today, was a proud member of the Massachusetts firefighters family. Today, you join that family. It's up to you to carry on that tradition of excellence, and I know that you will do that. This is a remarkable class of graduates. For Boston recruits, every one of these recruits is a veteran. And I want to thank you for your service to our country. You already know what it is to face danger and to protect others. I thank you for your service to our country. I am proud that now you have chosen to serve our city. You've taken on the responsibility of keeping our community safe. And it's our job to keep you safe. That's why over the last 3 years, we've taken historic measures to make sure that the Boston Fire Department has the resources they need to be successful. We're building Boston's first new firehouse in 30 years. We're starting in Dorchester and Roxbury. We're renovating two of the oldest firehouses in the city of Boston, Engine 50 in Charlestown and Engine 33 in the Back Bay. We've replaced every single oxygen tank with the best and safest technology available. We've created the tools that tell firefighters about building hazards even before they arrive on the scene. Last year, we replaced 50% of all of our ladder trucks in the city of Boston. And by the end of this year, we're going to purchase 23 new engines for our city. Throughout all of this work, we're relying on firefighters' feedback and guidance at every single turn. We've come a long way in helping Boston's firefighters stay safe and healthier, but we want to go even further. That's why this morning, when we unveiled the new budget, I presented to the City Council a proposal that would do just that. With over $500,000 pilot program that will reduce cancer risks for firefighters. It includes industrial cleaning of our firehouses. It includes nutrition training, physical education, mental health services, and so much more. All of this will help Boston firefighters have long and healthy lives long after they hang up their helmets, something that I'm sure that the commissioner will address in a little bit. This is a historic time for the Boston Fire Department, and none of these would be possible without the strong culture of teamwork we've developed between the Boston Fire Department and City Hall and the whole first responder community. I especially want to thank Commissioner Finn and Richie Parris for raising awareness about the long-term health risks firefighters face. They've certainly been strong advocates for occupational health and safety. On behalf of the City of Boston, Boston firefighters and their families, I want to thank you for your leadership. To all the graduates, once again, I want to say congratulations. Thank you for your hard work and commitment to keeping our community safe. Whenever I'm on the scene of a fire, watching our crews in action, I witness incredible acts of courage and teamwork. In this department, you have chosen to join the ranks. We know that you will rise to the challenge, and you will be an excellent addition to the public safety community. I look forward to watching your careers advance, working with you, and making our fire department even stronger. And I want to end by thanking all the family members here today. Thank you as well, because too often you don't get thanked. So to the mothers and fathers and grandmothers and grandfathers, the brothers and sisters, the wives and the husbands, everyone here, thank you very much for your support as well and your sacrifices. Because these young people to my right, when they went off and fought for this country, you were concerned. And today some of you are concerned, but I can tell you this, They're joining the best fire department in the country and in the world. Thank you very much.
The Fire Commissioner and Chief of Department, Joseph Finn.
Thank you. To Mayor Walsh, elected official, counselors, President Paris, Reverend Clergy, Father Dan, Reverend Thompson, good morning. To our newest firefighters, congratulations on this great and unforgettable day. You've truly earned it. How about a round of applause? I'd like to take a moment just to recognize the upper command staff of the Boston Fire Department, Chief of Operations, Gerard Fontana, Chief of Field Services, Chief of Operations and Support Services, Jackie Walsh, Deputy Commissioner of Labor, Human Resource and Legal Affairs, Connie Wong, Deputy Commissioner of Administration and Finance, Kathleen Judge, and Human Resource Director, Andrea Henley. I would also like to recognize Wellesley Fire Chief and President of the Fire Chiefs Association of Massachusetts, Rick DeLore. Also, Chelsea Fire Chief, Lenny Albanese. Malden Fire Chief, Kevin Finn. Dedham Fire Chief, Bill Spillane. And Marshfield Fire Chief, Billy Hawking. I would also like to recognize Deputy Chief Scotty Malone from the Personnel Division and his entire staff for their hard work in the recruitment, processing, vetting of candidates. You put together a great class. To our newest firefighters, I'd like to say first thank you for your military service. As the mayor stated, this class is 100% veteran. I don't have to tell you or your family and friends that only 1% of the country has been engaged in these conflicts since 9/11. Your dedication and sacrifice has made it possible for all of us to live with a sense of safety and security. It's that level of dedication and commitment I want you to bring to work every day as Boston firefighters. You are now proud members of the oldest and finest fire department in the nation. To the newest members of the Wellesley, Chelsea, Malden, Dedham, and Marshfield fire departments, I want to extend my heartfelt congratulations to you and your families. It's a great day for all. I hope the training you received at the Boston Fire Department Training Academy serves you well in the communities you'll be protecting. Know this. You've been trained by the best, and you will forever be part of the Boston Fire Department extended family. The many weeks of training and studying on Moon Island are finally over, and now the real world training begins. Our world is a very different place than it was on 9/11. Terrorism and the threat of terrorism are forever present, as we realized back on Marathon Monday in 2013 when evil came to the city of Boston. The training you received in fire ground operations, emergency medical response, hazardous material incidents, technical rescue, as well as terrorism, are all the foundation, are only the foundation. You need to continuously build upon those skills so you're always the best the city has to offer, and also to the communities you serve. The citizens of Boston and those who visit here deserve nothing less. And in saying that, a lot will be expected of you. And in return, you have the privilege of being called a Boston firefighter. Your training has been rigorous and demanding, and you are the first class of recruits to train with the new MSA G1 45-minute SCBA. This new respiratory protection will afford you an additional 15 minutes of air at the most critical period of fire attack. You're the third class to go through the O2X Human Performance Program. The first full week of training is dedicated to O2X. O2X is a holistic approach to health and wellness. It taught you how to increase your physical endurance and stamina, as well as the benefits of good nutrition, how to manage sleep deprivation, and with good stress management and behavioral health tools. We have set the goal of training the entire department in these techniques within 3 years. Currently, we have over 600 members trained in the O2X human performance concepts. And hopefully over the next two, the entire department will be trained in the program. The secret to longevity as a firefighter is being in peak physical condition and mentally resilient throughout your career. And the O2X program has given you the tools to do that. This is the third class who have completed the functional skill test. Functional skill test is much like an obstacle course. It has 13 stations, all job-specific tasks to simulate actual job functions on the fire ground. It is designed to replicate the stress and importance of being able to complete a task before moving on to your next assignment, much like the fire ground. You've seen the best training, and thanks to the unwavering support of Mayor Walsh, we will continue to move this job forward. I talk to the mayor on a regular basis. It could be about an overnight fire, or him just asking how things are going. His genuine concern for the well-being of his firefighters is always present in our conversation. He truly appreciates the hard work of the men and women of the Boston Fire Department. I would like to take a moment to publicly thank the mayor for all the capital investments he has made in the department. In a very short period of time, from new self-contained breathing apparatus to 9 new ladder trucks already in service, 9 in production, to 23 new engines that will be taking delivery very soon over the next 4 months, to 2 new firehouses that will be completed in the next couple of years, and to 2 that are going under renovation. All of this would not be possible without the support and commitment of Mayor Walsh. We've had more support from Mayor Walsh over these 3 short years than we had over the entire 20 years before that. And for that, Mayor, I say thank you. To the new firefighters, I wish you a long, healthy, and successful career. And keep in mind, you get out of this job what you put into it. So come to work every day with the attitude that you're going to make a positive impact in someone's life who really needs it. There's nothing more rewarding and gratifying than helping someone in their time of need. To the families and friends, congratulations. To you, you have witnessed firsthand that this was not an easy task. Enjoy the day because it is much yours as it is theirs. My thanks to the training division, under the leadership of Deputy Chief Michael Hawking, District Chief Tommy Blake, Drill Master and Captain John Gallagher, as well as all the instructors. Your hard work and dedication is truly appreciated. You've really made these recruits into firefighters. I thank you.
The President of Boston Firefighters Local 718, Rich Paris.
Thank you, Steve. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Florian Hall. My name is Rich Paris. I'm president of Local 718, proudly representing the men and women of the Boston Fire Department. First, I want to congratulate Father Dan. You've done a great job with us. During the hard times and with the last administration, you came down to our union meetings and made us sure that we were stuck together. So I want to thank you right now, Father Dan. Thank you very much for that. We're in good times now. Commissioner, Mayor, I want to thank you also, along with the City Council, for making our firefighters safer with the new rigs, the air packs, the firehouses. We can get along with this administration, and it works. And it's going to help these brand new recruits in their next 35 years working and staying safe. And that's what the union is about, making sure that our members are safe and they go home to their families at the end of their every tour. So I want to thank you once again, Commissioner, Mr. Mayor, and the City Council. To the families, congratulations. You've gone through a lot. It takes a lot, hoping your kid would, he served in the military, which is, I want to congratulate the families on the veterans. I want to congratulate all the veterans in this room. If they could please stand along with the veterans, you guys can stand if you want. We know you're all veterans, but how about a round of applause for all the veterans? Thank you for your service. To the recruits, it's all over. Not really. The academy's over. It just feels like yesterday we were sitting here. You're going to hear guys saying it goes by fast. I hear guys in the hall tonight saying I feel old. Well, I really feel old. I have a lot of friends' sons that are in this class right now. It's a great job. Enjoy it. Your training isn't over. When you start in the firehouse every day until the day you retire, you'll be training. You're going to meet friends, the guys that you went to drill school with, the guys sitting next to you. You might help them put a roof in the house. You might go to their weddings, the christenings. You're going to have a great friendship here. But during that role, you're going to lose some friends. And it's tough. But we have a brother and sisterhood that we stick together. It's a great family. And I want to see you guys continue the great family that we have in Boston and all through the state. I want to wish you all the best of luck, guys. You've had great training from Chief Hawking, Chief Blake, Captain Gallagher, right down to his crew right there. Remember what you learned in the academy, guys. You'll save someone's life. Most important, I want to see you all go home at the end of the tour and see you here every third Thursday at the union meeting. Good luck, guys. Thank you.
The drill master of the Boston Fire Academy, Captain John Gallagher.
Good morning, all. On October 31st, 2016, this recruit class convened at the Boston Fire Department Training Academy to begin 21-week firefighter training program. Today, I report to the mayor, Commissioner Finn, and the chiefs of the departments of Chelsea, Dedham, Malden, Marshfield, and Wellesley that the recruits of this class have completed and passed their initial firefighter training. All aspects of emergency response were addressed, both in the classroom and on the drill ground. With the knowledge learned and the skills acquired in hand, these recruits are ready to take their place alongside their fellow firefighters in service to the public they have sworn to protect. To the family, friends, and loved ones of the graduates, welcome to the extended family of the fire service. I report to you that these firefighters have been trained in the use of protective equipment which will help protect them while safely responding to and mitigating emergencies. They have also participated in a human performance program which provided them with tools to make them resilient to the mental and physical stresses that they will face. They are ready to report to their assigned companies where they will continue their training while serving their respective communities. To the graduating firefighters, you arrived at the training academy as individuals and graduated as a class. As a class, you committed to the task at hand, and you guys know what that task was, and achieved the highest passing rate on the Firefighter 1 and 2 certification in my tenure at the Training Academy. You performed above expectation in the practical training and live fire evolutions. You represented your departments honorably on the occasions when off-site training was conducted. You already go to the field where I have no doubt you will commit to the task at hand, which is the service to the public you are sworn to protect. Congratulations and a job well done. Lastly, all this could not have been accomplished without a dedicated staff to teach and instruct you both in classroom and on the drill ground. They have set the example, which is a leadership trait for you in many ways, but mostly importantly in teamwork that's been mentioned here today. Just as operations on the fire ground require a team effort, operations at the training academy require a team. So at this time, I would like to recognize the academy instructors for all the commitment, dedication, hard work that you brought you guys here today. So standing to my right to left, Lieutenant Robert Quinn, Lieutenant Daniel Gomes, Lieutenant Robert McGrath, Lieutenant James Haynes, Lieutenant Scott Boyle, Lieutenant Justin Yanisik, Instructor Michael Spence, Instructor Mariano Hernandez, Instructor Sheila Leahy, Instructor James McLaughlin, and representing the EMS division is Instructor William Benevelli. A round of applause, please. Thank you for your time.
All right, this time I'd ask the recruits to please grab your caps and please stand while the commissioner administers the oath of office. Please stand.
All right, some brief instructions here. After I say state your name, that's your name, okay? All right. All right. Please raise your right hand. Repeat after me. I state your name. Do solemnly swear or affirm. I'll support the Constitution of the United States. The Commonwealth of Massachusetts. And the ordinances of the City of Boston. I'll faithfully discharge the duties. Of a member of the Boston Fire Department. And I will obey the orders and directions of my superiors. To the best of my ability. Congratulations. Please be seated. All right, let me explain what's going to happen now. Is individually, each graduate is going to be coming up on stage to be presented a badge and certificate. As you see them sitting here in the seats, that's the order they're coming up. So anticipate when your loved one is going to be presented their badge and certificate, as we're going to have the person that is going to pin the badge come up, and then we'll have the rest of the family come up. We'll take a group photo on the stage after they're presented their badge and certificate. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Captain Gallagher to begin the proceedings.
To start us off is firefighter Christopher Amato being pinned by his father, Vincent Amato. Firefighter Jibril Intar, pinned by his father, Joseph Abbott. Firefighter Ronald Bigos, pinned by his father, Ronald Bigos.
Yes.
the family members come right up, please?
Firefighter Mark Bunzel, pinned by his father, Mark Bunzel. Firefighter Shane Burns, pinned by his father, William Burns. Firefighter Robert Canham, pinned by his father, Colin Canham. Firefighter Andrew Carey, pinned by his father, Boston firefighter Brian Carey. Thank you.
Professor Carey? Go ahead. Let's go. Hey.
Be as big as the Malone family.
How are you?
You should be.
Right now, I'm going.
Firefighter Jonathan Carrington, pinned by his father, Jonathan Green. Firefighter Raymond Chan, pinned by Fire Lieutenant Robert McGrath, Boston Fire Department. Firefighter Nicholas Costa, pinned by his girlfriend, Meg Hardiman.
Where's the baby? I'll get it after.
Firefighter Robert Craven, pinned by his mother. Boston Police Lieutenant Jacqueline Craven. Congratulations. Firefighter Patrick Culhane, pinned by his dad, Patrick Culhane. Firefighter Pierre Delaney, pinned by his wife, Kim Delaney. Firefighter Joshua Egan, pinned by his dad, Brian Egan. Firefighter Sean Finn, pinned by his dad, Fire Commissioner Joseph Finn, and his mom, Susan Finn. Firefighter David Garay, pinned by his mom, Zeta Martel. Firefighter Joseph Geary, pinned by his father, Joseph Geary. Firefighter Patrick Gorman, pinned by his wife, Reagan Gorman. Firefighter Gregory Hanley, pinned by his wife, Jennifer Hanley. Firefighter Joseph Hurley, pinned by William Hurley. William Hurley is Joseph's dad. Firefighter Larry Joseph, pinned by Janaya Joseph.
Thank you. sure I get this photo real quick.
Firefighter Daniel Keeler, pinned by his dad, Daniel Keeler. Firefighter Ryan Kenny, pinned by his mom, Kathleen Kenny.
Is this his birthday? Is this Lane's birthday?
Congratulations.
His birthday?
Firefighter Daniel Lane, pinned by his wife, Johanna Lane, on his birthday. On his birthday. Firefighter Paul Lombard, pinned by Paul and Elizabeth Lombard, mom and dad. Firefighter Scott McLean, pinned by Boston District Fire Chief Dennis Keeley and Deputy Chief Dan Carroll of Brookline Fire Department. Firefighter Robert Manning, pinned by Boston District Fire Chief Kevin Brooks. It's not me, it's them. Firefighter Patrick McCarron, pinned by his uncle, Boston firefighter Stephen Mullen.
I'm his proud dad.
Firefighter Francis McCarthy, pinned by his fiancée, Colleen Farrington. Firefighter Brian McHugh, pinned by Megan Cahill, his girlfriend. Firefighter Anthony McDonough, pinned by his wife, Emily. Firefighter John Patrick McManus, pinned by his dad, Kevin McManus. Firefighter Gary Morley, pinned by his fiancée, Brittany Clement. Firefighter Kevin Morris, pinned by his dad, Robert Morris, Detective Sergeant, Boston Police Department, retired. Firefighter Michael Norman, pinned by his son, Ian. Firefighter Kevin Oliver, pinned by his father-in-law, Fire Captain James Welsh, Boston Fire Department.
Come on, come on.
Yep. Firefighter Seth Parker, pinned by his wife Lauren and his son Ryan. Firefighter Patrick Finney, pinned by his wife, Amy, and his daughter, Nora. Firefighter Justin Poitras, pinned by his dad, Josh Poitras, Lowell firefighter. Firefighter Paul Sodergren, pinned by his mom and dad, Paul and Michelle.
Yeah.
Firefighter Paul Souza, pinned by his dad, Fire Lieutenant Paul Souza, Boston Fire Department, and Firefighter Michael Souza, his brother, Boston Fire Department. Mike. Firefighter Jared Sprague, pinned by his father, Massachusetts State Police Sergeant Ken Sprague. Firefighter Robert Stone, pinned by his son, Kyle. Firefighter Stephen Tobin, pinned by his wife, Jillian.
Family, you guys mind?
Oh, yeah, well, they, we can get them off. They did do their own. They've been chiefs.
Firefighter Stephen Tedesco, pinned by his dad, Stephen M. Tedesco. Firefighter Brendan Tully, pinned by his father, Deputy Chief Bernard Tully, Boston Fire Department. Firefighter Robert Vrabel, pinned by his uncle, Bill Vrabel.
Thank you.
Firefighter Joshua Waters, pinned by his brother, Jared. Firefighter Eric Ware, pinned by his dad, Peter Ware. That concludes the pinning of the Boston firefighter recruits. We're now going to check.
Hold on.
We still have the out of town, so can we have the chief of department of Chelsea come up to pin his recruits, please, to present. Morning, chief. Firefighter Keith Cameron, pinned by Deputy Chief Robert Cameron, his dad, Chelsea Fire Department.
Turn to the side, will you, Chief?
Firefighter Andrew Collin, pinned by his grandmother, Heidi Santiago. Firefighter Jonathan Morell, pinned by his mom, Elvira Gomez. We have the Chief of Dedham come to the stage, please. Morning, Chief. Firefighter Richard Becker, pinned by his wife, Sheila. Firefighter John Fontaine, pinned by his father, Deputy Chief of Dedham, John Fontaine, Jr.
Thank you.
Firefighter Kevin Galeazzo, pinned by his mom, Teresa Galeazzo, and his aunt, Linda Baldwin. Firefighter Matthew Jassett, pinned by Paul Antonio, retired Framingham Fire Department. Firefighter Sean Ledwidge, pinned by his father, John Ledwidge.
Thank you.
Firefighter Joseph Riley, pinned by his mom, Janice Riley Shaw.
That's it, Chief. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Could I have the Chief of Department of Baldwin's come to the stage, please? Firefighter Rodriguez Exelis. Pinned by his girlfriend, Emily Bruno. Firefighter George Katsaris, pinned by his father, Stephen West. We have the Chief of Department Marshfield come to the stage, please. pleasure. Excellent man. Firefighter Matthew Rader, pinned by his father, Douglas. We have the chief of the Wellesley Fire Department come to the stage, please. Firefighter Richard Delory. Pinned by his father, Chief of Department Wellesley Rick Delory. Firefighter Jared O'Neill, pinned by his grandfather, Robert Benelli.
How about a nice hand for our graduate recruits? For a presentation by the graduating class, I'd like to call up firefighter Anthony McDonough.
Mayor Walsh, Commissioner Finn, President Parrish, command staff, members, past and present, family and friends. I've been asked by the class of 31 October 2016 to say a few words on their behalf. Let me begin by saying I'd like to tell you what an honor it has been to be a member of this class. I could speak for hours about the personal attributes of each recruit that I hold in such regard. These young men have proven themselves to us and our city for a second time. I would also like to speak at length about the officers and instructors of Moon Island and their exemplary commitment to duty and dedication to training. But unfortunately, I must be brief. I would, however, like to take the time to make a statement of acknowledgement on behalf of the class. I would like to acknowledge the message that the mayor, the commissioner, the union, and our leadership have relayed on day one of the academy and every day since. That message has simply been that they care. To explain the significance of that statement, I must tell you how we collectively arrived at this understanding. You see, while our experience in the fire service is very limited, we are all veterans and have varying military backgrounds. It was this experience that we draw from to form an educated assessment of our leadership. A boot Marine and a buck private on their first day of the line size up their leadership and decide if they are good or bad. The fundamental question they need answered is, do they care about me? Simple. Historians study this, authors write about it, and leaders everywhere struggle with this simple analysis that even an 18-year-old rifleman understands. In the military, there is a mantra that describes this relationship between leader and subordinate. It is a statement: mission first, people always. It's used so often, it's a cliche. But in a world of cliche, this is one that always stuck in my head. The statement is a paradox. How can you put the mission first, but people always? It is an exercise in risk management. It is the challenge the leader faces when having to put their men in danger. What level of danger is acceptable? Where is the balance? The first part of the paradox is simple. Mission first. The military, not unlike the BFD, has a clearly defined mission statement supported by written SOPs, policies, techniques and tactics, and years of experience to draw from. This is what you train for. That's easy. The second half of the paradox is the hard part. People always. This is what that young soldier on the line is concerned about. It is what keeps that member's family awake at night. This is how he judges leadership. This is the true metric of a unit or organization. I didn't learn that in the academy. I, like my fellow recruits, learned that the hard way, thousands of miles away from here. For 5 years while leading troops, that statement rattled around my head and occupied my thoughts completely. And then I came home, and it simply vanished. That mental space was filled with the ordinary and mundane, happily. For 7 years, I never gave that paradox another thought. Then, in one day, I heard for the first time Commissioner Finn, Captain Gallagher, and Lieutenant Quinn speak to us as a class. That mantra entered my head again like a bullet, and for 20 weeks, it has been there. It came back because I knew that my new leadership have had that same thought forward in their mind. On day one, it was clearly obvious to me that this leadership really gets it. I mean, they really get it. I don't know how to read smoke, and I don't know what real heat feels like. But like all these young men, I can spot a leader at 1,000 yards. The lengths that this administration, department, and union have gone to put Boston first and members always is the big story here today. It will take hours to list these efforts made by these three organizations to ensure that we recruits and our families are cared for. For now, I'd just like to say to the administration and the department that your message has been sent, and on behalf of the 31 October 2016 class, message received, and thank you. And to my fellow recruits, I ask of you two things. One, explain to your families what I am talking about here. Tell them the details. Tell them what the commissioner told us yesterday. Explain to them that this is not ordinary, that this right now is special. Secondly, we now know what right looks like. When you know that, you can't claim ignorance. We now have seen how good things can be, must shoulder that responsibility to protect it and build on what we have been given. Thank you. I'd just like to call Firefighter Pat McCarron, Scott McLean, up on stage to present the class plaque. Sorry, every year there's a tradition that the graduating class presents a plaque that these two gentlemen took the responsibility and created. So we'd like to present this plaque with all of our names and companies and the badges from all our surrounding neighborhoods and towns. And there's the crest for all the branches of the military that we represent. On behalf of the class of 31 October 2016, to Captain Gallagher, Drill Master, and the department, thank you very much.
Close out our program, I'd like to ask you to please stand and invite our assistant chaplain, Reverend Kyle Thompson, for a closing prayer.
Hey, once again, congratulations to all of you today for this wonderful graduation ceremony. I just want to just quickly say, in the absence of Father Daniel Mahoney, who left the building, that I've worked with him since 2005 under Commissioner Christian and when I came on board. And Father Dan he's more than a giant. He's just a great man of God, a great priest, a great father of St. Francis de Sales. And we work in concert with each other, and we're here to provide care, a soul care, and to meet your needs when you need us. And many times we back each other up. And so if you need us, call the chaplain department, call the fire alarm, and they will get a hold of us, and we're here to help and to support you in whatever way possible. And I wanted to just publicly say that because as his assistant, he is a great, 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 great priest and a great father. And we should really publicly just give him a wonderful salute today as we get ready to close. Amen. With that being said, let's bow our heads in prayer. Eternal God, our Father, we thank you today for this wonderful celebration and this wonderful graduation experience. We thank you for every graduate from all the municipalities who are here today. We pray, oh God, that you would bless them and their families. We thank you for their diligence to study and to have proven themselves worthy of this recognition today by each municipality and, most important, the City of Boston Fire Department. We pray today that you would protect them from hurt, harm, and danger and the performance of each of their daily duties. And we pray that you would keep us and continue to bless us with good health, strength, and continued wisdom. Bless, O God, our commissioner and his wife and family, and bless the mayor of the City of Boston and all those who have collectively come together today to share in this wonderful day of celebration. We give you praise and give you thanks in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
That concludes the program. Enjoy the rest of the day.